गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास टू, आई एम ए कंप्यूटर टीचर संजीत सर। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3, इनपुट एंड आउटपुट डिवाइसेज। ओके, चैप्टर नंबर 3, इनपुट एंड आउटपुट डिवाइसेज। एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन आंसर। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। दिस इज द सिलेबस ऑफ द फर्स्ट टर्म एग्जामिनेशन एंड ऑल ऑफ यू नीड टू रीड ईच एंड एवरी चैप्टर वेरी वेरी केयरफुली फॉर योर फर्स्ट टाइम एग्जामिनेशन। ओके, प्लीज रीड ईच एंड एवरी चैप्टर। एंड दिस इज द कॉन्टेंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। एंड टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज इनपुट डिवाइसेज, आउटपुट डिवाइसेज एंड स्टोरेज डिवाइसेज। ओके, सो दिस थ्री कॉन्टेंट आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज इन दिस वीडियो। नाउ मूव ऑन टू द मेन टॉपिक। सो we know that the computer works according to the IPO cycle. Okay, and the parts of the computer that helps us to give the data and instruction are known as input devices. Okay, the parts of the computer that helps us to see or print the result of processing is known as output devices. Okay, so in my previous video I already have discussed that we give instruction to the input devices and after processing the result will be show or displayed in the output devices. Okay, so first is input devices. Input devices allows us to communicate with the computer. Okay, so, input devices allow us to communicate with the computer. The main uses of input device. Okay, the computer get instruction through the input devices such as keyboard, mouse, scanner and the microphone. Okay, so these are the four input devices. Okay, next is, first is keyboard. So this is the image of a keyboard. So a keyboard has many keys in it. We can enter data into the computer by pressing the various key. Here you can see the different types of keys are available on the keyboard. Okay, so number key, these are the number key, these are the alphabets key, these are the special keys. Okay, so there are various types of key available on the keyboard. So we use these keys to instruct the computer. Okay, next is mouse. So a mouse is also a input device. Okay, a mouse is usually has two buttons with a scroll wheel in between them. So here you can see this is the left button, this is the right button, and this is the small scroll wheel. Okay, the mouse is used to move the pointer on the computer screen. Okay, used to move the pointer on the computer screen, and we can select and open things by using the left button. Next is, we can draw by keeping the left mouse button pressed and moving the mouse. It known as dragging. Okay, it known as dragging the mouse. So keeping the left mouse button pressed, okay, keeping the left mouse button pressed and moving the mouse is known as dragging. Okay, next is, we can move a page up and down on the monitor by using the scroll wheel. The scroll wheel is mainly used for scrolling the page up and down. Okay, so these are the main uses of a mouse. Next is a scanner. A scanner is also an input device. So the scanner copies the text, okay, copies the text and pictures from paper onto a computer. Okay, so this is the main uses of a scanner. Scanners copies the text and pictures from a paper onto a computer. Okay, and we can scan our drawing from a sketchbook or any printed information in a book onto the computer using the scanner, and this is the image of a scanner. Okay, next is microphone, and this is the image of a microphone. Okay, so a microphone is used to input sound into a computer. Okay, input sound into a computer. It records our voice. Okay, it records our voice. Other different sound also. For example, we can narrate a story and get it recorded in a computer by using this microphone. Okay, and I am also using the microphone to record my sound in this video. Okay, next is, in 1827 Sir Charles Wheatstone was the first person to came up with the word microphone. Okay. And in 1876, Emily Barnalder invented the first microphone. Okay. Next is output device. So first output device is monitor, and the main output device is monitor. Okay. So I have already told that what is the uses of output device. Output device is used to display or print the result obtaining after processing of data. Okay. So first output device is monitor, and this is the image of a monitor, and this monitor is look like similar to television. Okay. And we can see pictures, movies and videos on the monitor. When we press any keys, okay, when we press any keys on the keyboard or use the mouse, these actions are also shows on the monitor. A monitor is also known as VDU, okay, visual display unit. Okay, the full form of video means visual display unit. And there are various types of monitors available. First is LCD, next is LED, and last is TFT. Okay, so there are three types of monitors. Okay, next is printer. This is the image of a printer. Okay, so a printer copies the information that we see on the monitor onto a paper. Okay, and the scanner is doing the opposite thing. Okay. So a printer copies the information that we see on the monitor onto a paper. The printed paper is known as printout. Okay, the printed paper is known as printout. Some printers can print only black and white, and some can print colorful printouts. Okay, there are various types of printers available in the market. For example, inkjet printer, laser printer. Okay, laser printer works very fast as compared to the other printers. Okay, so laser printer is the fastest printer. Okay, so the main thing about printer is the printer copies the information that we can see on the monitor onto a paper. Next is speaker. We all know that what is a speaker. We use the speaker to listen sound. Okay, so a speaker, we can listen to music and sound effect using the speaker. Okay, for example, we can listen our favorite song or poem using a speaker. We can also listen to music using headphones. Okay, headphones, the headphones allows us only to hear the music. Okay, headphone is different types. Okay, this is the image of a speaker, and the headphones allows only wearer to hear the music. Okay, next topic is storage device. Okay, so storage device means when we need to store something on a computer, then we need to use the storage device. Okay, storage device like hard disk, CD, DVD, pen drive, etc. Okay, so sometimes we may also need to store information for future use. For example, we may want to save our drawing in a computer so that can see them later. For this purpose, we use the storage device. And we use unit as a kilogram for weight and kilometer for the distance. Similarly, we use unit as a megabyte and gigabyte for the measuring the capacity of storage devices. Okay, megabyte and gigabyte. This is the unit of storage devices. Okay, so first storage device is hard disk. And this is the image of a hard disk. Okay, it is placed inside the computer, a CPU. Okay, so hard disk is the main storage device of a computer, and it is present inside the CPU box. It can store large amount of data. All the work done on a computer can be stored on the hard disk. Okay, so when working on a computer, on if anyone working on MS Paint to doing some pictures, okay, or anyone working on a Word document, all this document, all these pictures will save in the hard disk. Okay, Hard disk is the main storage device, and we use this hard disk to store the data. Next is CD or DVD. Okay, as you can see the round circle shape. Okay, so this is the image of a CD, and the DVD also look like same. Okay, so CD and DVDs are used to store large amount of data. They work when we insert into the CD and DVD drive. Okay, and this is the CD and DVD drive. Okay, writer, this is the CD and DVD writer. We need to put this CD or DVD in this slot. Okay, we can easily carry the CD and DVD one place to another place, and they can be used to store games and movies. A DVD can store more than a CD. Okay, the DVD can store more data than a CD. Next is a pen drive, and this is the image of a pen drive. Okay, so a pen drive is also a storage device, and which is small in size. Here you can see this is the small device, storage device. Okay, it can be easily carried in pocket or bag. It is also used to store and transfer data from one computer to another computer. Okay, so the main uses of this storage device is to store and transfer the data from one computer to another computer. Next is the bookmarks from this chapter. First is input device. We all know that we give instruction to the computer, and we use a keyboard, mouse, microphone, microphone and scanner. These are the input devices. Okay, we use these input devices to instruct the computer. Okay, next is output device. After processing the data, the computer will generate a result, and this result will be displayed on the output devices like monitor, speaker, okay, etc. Next is keyboard. Keyboard is an input device. Okay, keyboard is an input device, and it has many keys on the keyboard, and it is used to enter data on a computer. Next is mouse. Mouse is also an input device, and it is used to pointing and selecting on a computer. Next is scanner. Scanner is also an input device, and it copies the text and pictures from a paper onto a computer. Okay, next is microphone. Microphone is also an input device, and it is used to input sound into a computer. Next is monitor. Monitor is the main output device of a computer. Okay, and it is also known as video. Video means visual display unit. Okay, next is printer. An output device that is used to display text and pictures on paper. Okay, next is hard disk. Hard disk is the main storage device of a computer, and it plays inside the CPU box. Okay, it plays inside the CPU box, and it can store large amount of data, huge amount of data. Okay, next is the question answer part. First is choose the correct option. Number one is choose the correct option. Okay, A. So number one is, which of the following device cannot be used to store the output for later use? Okay, so monitor, we all know that monitor is the output device, not storage device. Okay, other three options are storage device, like pen drive, DVD and hard disk is the storage device. Next is the result of processing are displayed on using the output devices. Okay, next is number three, which of the following device is used for copying text and images from a paper onto a computer? So the option number B is the correct answer, scanner. Okay, we use the scanner to copying text and images from a paper onto a computer. Okay, next is number four, which of the following is an output device? So printer is the right answer. Okay, we use the printer to print the output or print the result. Okay, next is tick the correct statement and cross the wrong one. Okay, फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज, फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज, द स्टोरेज डिवाइस आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शन टू द कंप्यूटर. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स. ओके, वी यूज द इनपुट डिवाइसेस टू गिव इंस्ट्रक्शन टू द कंप्यूटर. नेक्स्ट इज, डीवीडीज आर कैपेबल फॉर स्टोरिंग मोर देन डेटा सीडीज. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट इज, ए माइक्रोफोन इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आउटपुट डिवाइस. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ऑल्सो इनकरेक्ट. माइक्रोफोन इज अ इनपुट डिवाइस. वी यूज द माइक्रोफोन टू स्टोर रिकॉर्ड आवर साउंड. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज, ए पेन ड्राइव कैन बी यूज टू स्टोर एंड ट्रांसफर डेटा फ्रॉम वन कंप्यूटर टू अनदर कंप्यूटर. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट इज नंबर फाइव, प्रिंटर कैन बी यूज टू गिव इंस्ट्रक्शन टू द कंप्यूटर. दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. फर्स्ट इज, यू कैन सिलेक्ट एंड ड्रॉ थिंग्स ऑन ए मोनिटर बाई यूजिंग ए माउस. ओके, सो माउस इज नंबर वन. नेक्स्ट इज, स्पीकर हेल्प्स अस टू लिसन म्यूजिक. सो स्पीकर इज नंबर टू. नेक्स्ट इज, ए माइक्रोफोन इज यूज टू रिकॉर्ड आवर वॉइस. सो माइक्रोफोन इज नंबर थ्री. And last is, the scroll wheel in a mouse helps us to moving a page up and down on the monitor. So scroll wheel is number 4. Okay, next is, identify the device that can be used in the following situation. So first is, to listen your favorite song we use the speaker. Okay, next is, to get a soft copy of your annual function photograph on the monitor. Okay, next is, to submit a typed poem for your school magazine printer. We use the printer to submit a poem, typed poem of your school. Okay, next is, to record your voice as a voiceover for a play. We use the microphone. Next is number 5, to transfer songs from one from your laptop to desktop. We use the pen drive. Pen drive is a storage device. Okay, next is, answer the following question. Number 1, how is the printer different from a scanner? So first is scanner. A scanner is an input device and printer is the output device. Okay, this is the main difference. Okay, scanner is an input device and printer is the output device. Now scanner copies the text and picture from a paper onto a computer. Okay, from a paper onto a computer, and printers copies the information onto a paper. Okay, so this is the another very very important difference between a scanner and a printer. Next is, name some storage device that can be easily carried around. Pen drive, CD, DVD. Okay, next is, list any two functions of a mouse as an input device. So we can select and open things on a computer. This is the first uses of a mouse. Next is, we can move a page up and down on the monitor by using the scroll wheel. This is the second use. Okay, next is, some tick mark from inside the chapter. Okay, so first is, a device is used to record our voice. So microphone is the correct answer. Next is, a device that copies the text and pictures from a paper onto a computer. So option number B is the correct answer, scanner. Next is, a device that enables us to move a page up and down on the monitor. So we use the mouse. Next is number 4, a device that enables us to type numbers and words. So we use the keyboard. Okay, so these are the some tick marks from inside the chapter, and all of you have to write all these question answer on your computer copy and also learn it. Okay, and please read each and every chapter very carefully for your first term examination. Okay, so today I am ending my discussion here. In my next video I will revise another chapter. Okay, so till then, take care, goodbye and thank you.